Hello, people of God. We thank God so much for how far the Almighty God has brought us. We thank God for yet another day for His protection and guidance upon our lives. Upon all this situation we are in now, the Almighty God have mercy for us. Grace to how we are still living and existing. We thank God for that. Today, I won't waste my time. As you already know, my name is Dr. William. Today, I'm here to share a few words with you as I was given. We are going to tackle a chapter here at 2 Timothy. So 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 1 to 5. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 1 to 5. I'm going to take them one by one and explain them. So without wasting my time, let's have a word of prayer. We thank you, Lord, how far you've brought us. We commit our studies into your hand. Come and give understanding of the word in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 1 to 5. So 2 Timothy 3, 1 to 5, and I read, This know also, that in the last days, perilous times shall come. When we talk of perilous time, the word perilous means he's talking about danger, the danger day, risk day shall come. And verse 2 said that, so this danger zone that we are talking about is as this time as we are. Example is at this time that we are in. Imagine this coronavirus that has what come, this pandemic what situation that we are in. The whole world, everybody is shutting down. Everybody is what? Shutting down. Countries are shutting down their borders and airports to the extent that everybody is what, trying to mind his own what, business. You are getting it. So a danger time like this one. He said, verse 2, for men shall be lovers of their own selves. Men will love, shall be lovers of their own selves. So like I explained, now every country is in a serious situation. So every country is trying to mind its own business, trying to what? Protect their people, trying to help their people. So now nobody is what, trying to go and help another, because we are all in a trouble. So men shall love themselves. I am in a problem, I am afraid that when I go out, when I go to my friend, if my friend is having coronavirus, I can get it. So then I am protecting myself, I am isolating myself because I want to protect myself in order to prevent myself from getting this what, virus. Men shall be lovers of what? Themselves. You know, and he said, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemous, disobedient of parents, and untransferable, and what? Unholy. Let me tell them one by one. Boasters. We have so many people who be boasting of what? Themselves. This person will be so proud of themselves. Do you know who I, you know, some people can say, do you know who I am? Do you know the office I hold? Do you know what I'm capable of doing? Do you know what I'm capable of doing to you? People will be what? Boasted of themselves. So proud, so arrogant. Blasphemous, disobedient of parents. Children will be so disobedient to parents. When parents give advice, children will not listen to you. Children will like to do their own thing, will like to do what they think is good for them. Disobeying their parents, rules and regulations, forgetting the promises and the words and the warning God gave, that children, obey your parents in the Lord so that your life shall be longer on earth. They will be forgetting all these things and disobeying what their parents. Untruthfulness, people will be ungrateful to people. You know, you'll be doing things for people, be helping people, and they'll be grateful. They'll be paying you back with what? With tarnishment of image. You'll be so surprised. Sometimes you'll be so surprised to the extent that somebody that you have helped, somebody that you have what? You have even like sacrificed for, will go and tarnish your image to others. You go and say bad things about you to others. Ungrateful, unthankfulness, unholy. People will be doing so many of what? Sins, committing so many sins, forgetting, defying their body, defying themselves. Some can go extreme of what? Of sowing their body to the devil for fame, sowing their body money to the devil for in order to get name. Some can go to the extent of sowing their body for what? For money. Some can go to the extent of doing immoralities, smoking, drinking, destroying their system, their own organ. When you tell them, they will say, this is my life, this is my body. I'm telling you, don't own your body. One day the owner of that body will come. Verse 3, without natural affection, trust breakers, false accusers, incontinent, yes, and despise of those that are good. They will be what? Trust breakers. People will break trust. You will so trust somebody, you so trust your pastor, you so trust your friend, you so trust somebody. So then you go and share something that a problem that you think, you know, like when I see this person, I can get advice. I can tell me what to do. And you'll be so surprised at what you told the person. That person will go and disclose to another person. And you'll be there and what? All that, what you call it, a secret that you have told a friend. Your friend have what, broadcast it all along, destroying your name. All these things, what will be happening, and people will be what? Be disappointed among what? Each other. That be despising their goods. People that are doing good. And you see, people are saying bad things against them, saying all sort of things that they are not, what they don't have evidence on. They are saying it, of which you don't have evidence on, despising them. Verses say traitors. People will be traitors. Organization, group. They'll be discussing of something, plan that they are going to do. And you say one of them will go and be a traitor. Go and tell a different person. Go and broadcast it out. As Judas what? Judas was a traitor to Jesus Christ. He traitor Jesus Christ by sowing him to the people. You know, hidden, high-minded. People be so high, what? Minded of themselves. Lovers of pleasure, of more than lovers of God. People will love pleasures. You know, let me tell you one thing. Wherever that we tell the rich is a sin, is a liar. Rich is not sin. God is not a poor person. You understand? God is never a poor person. God is rich. He said, in my father's house, there are so many masses full of gold. So God is rich. Being rich is good. Buying cars, being the richest man, getting money is never a sin. But the way you handle it, like to the extent that you so valued your pleasure, your money, your cars, your house, your properties, than God, than the things of God. Like you so loved the things that you are having than the word of God, to the extent that even if it's time for God, time for God for services, said, I have to visit my customers, I have to travel, I have to do this, leaving the work of God there. That one, you are putting your pleasure, your love into the thing that you have than God. That makes it what? You sin, because you love your riches than what? Than God. That makes you sin. But the rich itself is never a sin. Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn what? Away from. Let us turn away from all those things. You know, we are in the end time. When I was doing the Bible eschatology, Bible eschatology talk about what? Bible teachings. I came about the Great Tribulation, and I came about the word pandemic. The word pandemic means critical diseases, viruses that have no what? Cure. They will pronounce it as a pandemic. Example, the HIV AIDS. Now we don't have a cure for HIV AIDS, so it has been declared as a pandemic. Ebola came, coronavirus is in. It has been declared as what? A pandemic, a global what? Disease, a global virus. Now, but Jesus said, the end time, these are some of the signs that will be showing, that will show my coming, that my coming is what? Approaching. You understand? So we are approaching the end time. Let us prepare our hearts, ourselves for God, because that at the end day, all that we are seeing around us are the things that Jesus said that they will be happening. When is the end time, and where will your heart be? Where will your soul be? Put your life in the things of God. Love God, love your neighbors. You understand? Guess what? Just this virus, a tiny animal organism. It is a microscopic organism. We can't use our naked eyes to see unless what? The help of microscope. And just this has put fear and panic to every what? Individual, all countries. You understand? So they say everybody is minding his own business, trying to protect his people. Now nobody is going to help other. You understand? So put your trust in God and let us pray. And I hope that everything with God, all things are possible. I know God will save us and will save us all. God bless us all. And may God take off this virus issue and heal our land. Second Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14. If my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and ask for forgiveness of sin, I the Lord shall hear them from heaven and forgive them and will heal their land. Call upon God. If you are not born again, repent and ask for forgiveness of sin and God will forgive you. My name is Dr. William. I would like to appreciate you. Thank you for your time. For listening to the word of God. Thank God to Dr. Faith who have been helping and pushing the word of God forward. God bless you so much. Have a wonderful day. Enjoy your day. Bye-bye.